morning I really fancied a little stool in the bathroom. That sounds really bad. That sounds bad. Doesn't it sound bad? Like a table, I suppose. One of my luxuries is I like having a cup of tea when I'm in the bath, and I thought, wouldn't it be great to have a special place to put my cup of tea? And maybe I could also put a book or a magazine on there to read in the bath. How nice would that be? And then depending on where I position the table or the stool, I could maybe reach the book or magazine from the toilet. Now, not everybody will admit to this, but I will raise my hand and say that I like to read on the toilet. Give us a cheer. Any men who like to read on the toilet?
Yeah.
Any women?
Yes.
See, interesting, because one of my friends said to me, you don't tell people you do that, do you? I said, yeah. She said, I don't think you should. I said, why not? She said, I don't think it's very ladylike. I said, have you seen who you're talking to? I said, and anyway, I'm not sure what you mean, because as far as I'm aware, there's nothing ladylike about doing a shit. Picture the scene. I'm sitting down, my legs are apart, my elbows are resting on my knees. I might be sweating. If it's a hard one, I could have taken my top off. But to make up for all of that, I do it exactly the same. But to make it ladylike, I do it all in a fucking bonnet. Those two words aren't together often enough, are they, fucking bonnet? You're never going to get that in a Pride and Prejudice, are you? Why, Mr. Darcy, what do you think of me fucking bonnet? Second thing I decided to do, I decided to get a pet. I've always grown up with pets, and in my teens and in my 20s. And then there's something about the lifestyle of being a comedian that means you're on the road a lot. It's not really conducive to having animals at home. And then I thought, you know, I've done this 8 years. Maybe it's time the lifestyle worked around me for a change. So I really wanted a cat. So I got a cat 2 years ago. I got another cat last year. My fella seems to think I just wanted two cats. He doesn't realise it's now an annual event. The second cat we got is a rescue cat. She was just left outside of the vet's in a box overnight, just left. And she's lovely. She's very affectionate. Whenever my fella picks her up, she starts purring straight away. And he looks her right in the face and he goes, who would abandon you?
Who would abandon you?
I said, stop saying that to her. It's like somebody saying to me, who would divorce you? Someone fucking did.
Hi, I'm Sarah Millican, and thanks very much for watching my video. I'm on tour at the moment with a show called Bobby Dazzler. To find out where I'm going and when, go to sarahmillican.co.uk. Thanks. Bye.